They are traditional slow starters to the season, Sheffield Wednesday, but they always seem to produce their very best when the visitors are Manchester United. So we're all set for one of the games of the day in the English Premiership. And it's Sheffield Wednesday who get us underway. Phil Neville, that's a lovely little ball. Roy Keane. Oh, a great ball for Blomqvist. Took it beautifully and tried to chip it over the goalkeeper. Wonderful football from Manchester United. The vision of Keane, that's what Blomqvist is acknowledging now. If only he could have produced the finish to match that build-up. Jesper Blomqvist would have been celebrating only his second goal for Manchester United. His first came in the 4-1 victory at Everton in their last away game. But just judged it wrong, well over in fact. Ronnie Wilson suffered a 7-0 hammering at the hands of Manchester United last season when he was in charge of Barnsley, now his first season in charge at Sheffield Wednesday. Hinchcliffe's free kick, aimed at Booth. Carboni's ahead of him, Alexanderson in behind it. And he tries the shot! Oh, it's in! It's a goal! Peter Schmeichel couldn't keep it out, and Nicholas Alexanderson gives Sheffield Wednesday the lead inside 15 minutes. What a start for Danny Wilson and his players. And here's Manchester United's Hillsborough jinx going to strike again here. It was a beautifully hit left-foot shot, but frankly, you would have expected Peter Schmeichel to deal with it. It was straight at him, and he mishandled it and paid an embarrassing price. Only the second goal that Nicholas Anderson has scored for Sheffield Wednesday, and his first in the Premiership, the other in an FA Cup tie against Watford last season. Here's David Beckham, standing still forward from that earlier attack. He doesn't know quite what to do with it now, though. Or does he? Well, I've done him a disservice. He's picked out Scholes, who picks out Blomqvist. Four in the box for Manchester United here, and the header by Cole. Sandy Cech relieved to see that go wide. Andy Cole with 7 goals this season, and with an excellent record in years gone by against today's opponents, Sheffield Wednesday, but wide of target this time. Ferguson looks on anxiously. His team have not made a good start here. Alex Ferguson making his views known very vociferously down there on the touchline. He recognises that his team are not playing to their capabilities at the moment. But that would be doing a disservice also to Sheffield Wednesday. They have started brightly. Neville in possession, however, for United. But that was a brilliantly crafted goal by Manchester United. Neville, Cole, York, back again to Cole, and the finish, what you've come to expect from Andy Cole. His 8th goal of the season, and his intuitive partnership with Dwight York pays dividends again. They knew exactly where each other were going to run in that build-up. Great finish. And Dennis Irwin. And he found a gap beautifully there. And has found Dwight York, who leaves it to Irwin, who goes down. And a very confident appeal for a penalty from the Manchester United players who've surrounded David Ellery and Alex Ferguson. Sees the funny side of it. Well, that was a very strong penalty claim. Irwin floored in the box. I think the smile was one of resignation from the United manager. Keeper delivers it long and quickly. Taken down well by little Benny Carboni, but he's lost out in the physical battle, inevitably, to Stam, who's done well here for his team. 4 forward in this Manchester United attack, and he keeps going, and Cernicek forced to push it away for a corner. Still waiting for his first Manchester United goal, Yapstam. He must have thought it could be arriving here. The gap opened up and he just filled it. Good effort. Mr. Ellery has told the fourth official there will be no added time at all. Scholes. Here's York. Back again to Scholes. On to Andy Cole. Lovely football this from Manchester United. Beckham on the right. Can they round it off with a goal here? Scholes was well placed. And they're happy for the corner. There's Walker's clearance. Well, if the referee is correct in not adding any time, then we're into the final seconds here. West Ham comes in behind everyone. And it's gone in, has it? I'm sure there was the use of a hand there, and in fact, that is the case. The free kick has been given, and there's a bit of an argument developing inside the penalty area. I must say, I did see a hand go out there, and the referee will presumably produce a yellow card. Paul Scholes, who has upset the referee more than once in this game with some of his tackles early on, is yellow carded for his attempt there to hoodwink the officials. But it would have been all right if he'd been playing for the Harlem Globetrotters, but in a football match, not allowed. Peter Rudy coming forward for Sheffield Wednesday, sets one up for Sonner. Thought about hitting it first time, lays it off instead, and in it goes towards Booth. Oh, it's a good save, but it'll surely be knocked in. The rebound has been, and Sheffield Wednesday are back in the lead. Well, Peter Schmeichel might have one or two question marks against him again, but Vin Jonk and Sheffield Wednesday aren't complaining. Alexanderson with a little ball. Booth played it straight against the Manchester United keeper, and Vin Jonk was perfectly placed to slide home his first ever goal for Sheffield Wednesday. And Manchester United find themselves behind for the second time in a match here at Hillsborough. Ten minutes gone in the second half. The early cross. Anderson wins the loose ball, then gets it back from Sonner. Ooh, Schmeichel in trouble with the cross, which I'm sure it was, rather than an intended shot. But he's not been at his best today, Peter Schmeichel. It's a routine ball just knocked in the general area of the far post, and he was outstretched to keep it away. Beckham. Shot coming here. And not far wide. Well, you could tell from his body shape that he was lining up an effort there. Just found enough room for himself, and that was close. Anderson for Sheffield Wednesday. Carboni. Oh, that's an ambitious ball. Beckham read it well, but a mistake by Stam, and Alexanderson could be in again. His second of the game. A delighted Danny Wilson shakes his fist with joy, not anger, and there's joy all around Hillsborough as Sheffield Wednesday extend their lead to 3-1. Carboni with a clever overhead kick. Beckham just guided it back, but Stam's first touch let him down. Alexanderson was determined, and once he'd got round Schmeichel, the outcome was inevitable. And Sheffield Wednesday, yet again, seemed to be on the way to victory against Manchester United. It It looked a routine clearance from United's point of view, but Alex Sanderson made sure it wasn't to be. And suddenly, Young has it back again for Sheffield Wednesday, and Schmeichel has produced a wonder save there, to be fair. Manchester United carelessly giving the ball away, and although Schmeichel's had his problems today, he did brilliantly here. Roy Keane's mistake uncharacteristically, but Schmeichel stretched out one of those huge hands and kept the ball from dropping over him for what would have been a further Sheffield Wednesday goal and a killer goal. Carboni. It's a good ball, and Booth is onside and really should have scored to make victory absolutely certain if it isn't already. Carboni with the ball. Gary Neville didn't realise Booth was behind him, and Schmeichel again did well. It's just not coming right for United today, and they have been beaten. What a result for Sheffield Wednesday. Wim Jonk's first goal for the club, two by Nicholas Alexanderson. And Manchester United have now failed to beat Sheffield Wednesday on their last five visits to Hillsborough, and they've managed victory against them only once in the last nine league games against today's opponents. And Sheffield Wednesday, remarkably, have managed only two wins in their last 11 matches. One of them was against Arsenal, and now they've beaten Manchester United.